Here we go then. So Van Doorn on the right, Rossi on the left, and we're here for the penultimate race of the season one GP2 season. One light, two lights, three lights, four lights, five lights. And it's go here in Spielberg. And it looks like Rossi's got a fantastic start. Rossi takes the lead. And it looks like Harry Hunter's trying to take second place off Van Doorn. Van Doorn's had a shocking start. They go up into turn one. Rossi leads, but can Harry Hunter take second place? We go into turn one. Look at Razia. Razia is up into third position. It's going side by side with Van Doorn as everyone got through the first corner safely. I believe they have. Yes, they have. Rossi leads the race and Van Doorn is squabbling, trying to take back that position. He's Razia in third position. They go up the hill towards the rear's curve. Van Doorn going down to the inside of Rossi. Oh, that was close indeed, but Rossi just managing to hang it around the outside. Harry Hunter looked like he'd taken a wider line into the Remus curve there. Evans has also had a terrible shot. Where's Magnussen? Where is Magnussen? He's not down there, is he? Magnussen's up to fifth, actually, so good stuff for him. Razia down the inside of Van Doorn. Can he get second place? Yes, he can. Razia moves up into second place, and Van Doorn has not had the start that he wants. This is not what he wants for his championship contention, and that's certainly what not Magnussen wants either, because Rossi is out in front, leading here in Spielberg. There he is. He's got a bit of a comfortable gap in front of Louis Razia right now, as Van Doorn's holding up a bit of a train as Stevens looks to be in an Etihad sandwich. But then again, Magnussen's all over his backside. He might want to have a look. In fact, but Stevens looking to the inside of Van Doorn going into the second last corner. Can he pull it off? No, not quite. Van Doorn just hanging around the outside there. Is that what Magnussen need to play? Let's see as they go around the final corner. And down the pit straight to go. Rossi sets the fastest lap of the race. Now Razia takes the fastest lap of the race. So far, Razia holding on to the two bonus points. That's not free of breath, surely. Actually, Stevens going side by side with Van Doorn. Can he take third? Yes, he can. Stevens moves into third position. And now, Magnussen's in the clutches of his former teammate, Julian Palmer. Palmer side by side with Magnussen. He's thinking, we're not teammates anymore. I don't need to help you for this championship. Side by side to go. But Magnussen just seems to have the legs as they go up to the rear. Go. Van Doorn trying to get Stevens back for third position, but Stevens was able to defend the position. Palmer going down the inside of Magnussen, and Palmer is up into fifth position. Lynn now all over the back of Magnussen, and even Evans wants a piece of this as well. This is a fantastic start to the race we've had so far, and well, what can you say? There's a little bit of squabbling behind. Looks like Sainz had a terrible start down to 21st at the start. Lynn tried to have a look at Magnussen, but not quite. Harry Hunter's all the way down in ninth at the moment. A terrible start from fourth position right now, as it looked like app defended from Daly there. As at the moment, Rossi leads, Razia second. I wonder if Razia's actually catching to Rossi right now, because that looks a little bit closer than what he did on the previous lap. Meanwhile, Stevens all over the back of Van Doorn, because I think Van Doorn actually took him back for third position. So I'm guessing it's probably down at turn three. Van Doorn got him back, but now Stevens wants a piece of him down at the second last corner. Can he get it? No, again, Van Doorn just hanging it around the outside as they go through the last corner right now. At the moment, Rossi leads, Razia second, Van Doorn first, Stevens fourth, Palmer fifth, Magnussen sixth, Lane seventh, and Mitch Evans rounding out the top eight. Can Stevens try and get it back down into turn one? Looking back down the inside, Van Doorn trying to squeeze him into the pit wall there. That's Apt out of the race. Apt is out of the race.
So if he's not going
to
be Apt then.
What's Daniel Apt? What's happened to Daniel Apt? And, he's beached it. He's beached it. Who pushed him off? Who pushed Daniel off? It looks like he's beached the car. Looks like somebody pushed him off. We need to have a look at a replay of that. And no, we just caught onto it late. So I don't know if he got tagged by someone or he just made a complete and utter mistake. Looks to me like a mistake, because that's kind of a weird place for someone to go for an overtake. Unless your name's Pastor Maldonado. But, Apt, there you go, confirmation. Apt out of the race, beaches it at turn six. That's actually quite close to where that roll out, and Stevens gets back third position. But can Van Doorn try and get him back now? He might have to keep an eye on Palmer. Look at this train of cars as they all head to the Remus curve. Look at the amount of cars battling for third right now. Stevens, Van Doorn, Palmer, Magnussen, Lynn, Evans, even Harry Anto's got into the mix as well. And maybe Gasly and Giotto's going to get into it as well. Close stop. Look at this. This is carnage. It's Magnussen looking to the inside of Palmer. Oh, that was close. Van Doorn anyway tagged him there. Magnussen takes back fifth position off Palmer. And look at this. There's a train of cars. There's even a lockup in the background. I think that was think that was it caused a little bit of a traffic jam going up the hill. Exactly, tried to find a way past signs there. And side by side, got the two teammates. Magnussen goes side by side. And Magnussen takes four for Van Doorn. Van Doorn's just going backwards all of a sudden. And Stevens in a podium position right now. Can he finally get Yorkshire's first ever points? That is the big question. That will be the thing to end Yorkshire's season off, because that would be something for them indeed. Looks like this three-way car scrapped for seven. Looks like Van Doorn. Looks like he slipped back a bit, and now Palmer wants to try and take Van Doorn for fifth position as they go up the hill towards the second of the last corner. He's trying his best to get up close with the Etihad. He might have to wait down the pit straight, though. We'll have to wait and see. Rozier, what's the gap between him and Rossi right now? And we'll check up on this gap to see if he is actually gaining. Going up to turn one, and the gap is... come on. 3.1. And Van Doorn having to defend from Palmer into turn one. So keep an eye on that gap then between Rossi and Rozier. Side by side goes Lynn's having to try and again find a way past Palmer. And Evans wants to try and get in the mix. Side by side we go. Looks like there's nearly three abreast going up the hill. Lynn gets up to six. Three abreast up the hill. Charlene are not all going to make it. Harry Anto going for a risky move indeed. And what a move from Harry Anto. Moving up into 7th place, a great pass from the Indonesian driver. And now look at this, Evans is under pressure from Giotto. Evans is currently outside the points right now. This is not what he wants. And now Lynn looking to the inside of Van Doorn for 5th. Can he get the job done? Side by side to go. They go side by side and Lynn takes 5th. Looks like Harry Anto's trying to find a way past. Well, defending from Palmer. Palmer's trying to find a way past Harry Anto. But luckily, Harry Anto was able to keep the door shut. And now Harry Anto's all over the backside of Van Doorn for 6th position. This is a mad race in the opening laps. And, wow. As now Magnussen wants to get onto the back of Stevens. Harry Anto, though, on the back of Van Doorn, looking to the inside. Into the second to last corner. And, oh, Van Doorn just shut the door on him there. And now Harry Anto's got to watch his mirrors with Palmer and Evans behind. And we didn't see what the gap between these two was. What was it? 4.1. So Rossi is pulling away. There's no increase in the gap. And, oh, I forgot to record it. Damn. I'll have to download the Twitch stream later on. But, anywho, look at this. Four-way scrap at the moment. Harry Anto trying his best to get on terms with Van Doorn. In fact, he might have to worry about Palmer. Palmer's looking to the inside. No, in fact, Evans is trying to look for a way past down the inside. Palmer down the inside of Harry Anto, and he takes 7th off Harry Anto. And now Evans trying to get alongside Harry Anto, but not quite. Like, Evans has to tuck in behind for now, and they've brought Giotto, Gasly, Leclerc, Marcello, Rahal, Masashita, and a bit more into this fight as well. This is a mad race. Harry Anto looking back down the inside of Palmer. And side by side they go, but it looks like Palmer's just hung in around the outside, and Palmer keeps 7th place for now. And I wonder what the Twitter chat is like right now, because this is just mad. This is a mad race so far. Oh, probably in the Twitch chat then. So Harry Anto then defending from Evans. Evans trying to get the point off Harry Anto. Up the hill they go then. Evans looking to the inside of Harry Anto for 8th position. Danny inside. Not quite. Harry Anto just hangs it around the outside. They go through the last corner. What lap are they on? Rossi's now on lap 6 of 43. We cross the line. And now Evans tucked up onto the back of Harry Anto. Danny inside. And it looks like Leclerc's trying to find a way past Gasly for 11th. But Gasly closed the door. Evans, Danny inside. But Harry Anto able to hang it around the outside. Giotto's into this fight now. And it looks like there's a train of cars fighting for 11th right now. Three-way scrap for 8th position. This is probably going to be a long highlights at this rate when I get round to editing Spielberg. But now up the hill then. Looks like lots of stuff going on. No changes so far. Giotto trying his best to get past Evans, but not quite. Evans, he's going to have to tuck in behind right now. Harry Anto pulls away just a little bit because Evans and Giotto were fighting a little bit. And they've brought, I think, Gasly into this fight now. And Marcello, Leclerc. And I think that is Rahal, if I'm correct. So, meantime... Wait! Hang on! Magnussen's up to third! Unseen by the cameras, Magnussen's on the podium! Magnussen's gone up to third position! He had to do that because look who's leading at the moment! Rossi is currently leading the race. And meantime, let's get back, as it looks like everyone's starting to spread themselves out just a bit after, well, all the chaos that was happening, it has to be said. But meanwhile, look at this gaggle of cars coming down the pit straight now. We're on lap, I think it's lap 7, I think, of 43, as they head into turn 1. And look at Leclerc now. Leclerc looking to the inside of Marcello, and Leclerc gets up into 12th. Marcello is now in the clutches of Rahal, who's looking to the inside. Can he get him before the rim is curved out? Side by side go Marcello and Rahal. Side by side to go up the hill. Rahal looking to the inside. It's more side by side action. Matsushita looks like he's fighting with Newgarden, but not quite. Matsushita looking to the inside. Not quite. That was so close to contact, in fact. Side by side action on the two GRMs. Nick Yelly's passing Mano Di Silvestro. And Magnussen's next target is Louis Rozier for second place. So, Magnussen then, just going around that left hander. And this is just a mad race so far. I even need a drink after that. So, Magnussen currently in third position. Giotto having to defend from Gasly for 10th position. Is he able to get in a position now? Let's see. Danny inside he goes. Is he able to get him side by side? Not quite. Looks like Giotto was able to hang it around the outside through the last corner to go. They all. Rossi is now on lap 8 of 43. Gasly tucking up into Giotto's slipstream. He's looking in the inside. Side by side to go. And can Gasly get the position side by side into turn 1? Not quite. Giotto just hangs it around the outside. And Leclerc now got into this fight as well. Gasly side by side go Gasly and Leclerc. And Leclerc has taken 11th off Gasly. Hey, beautiful stuff. Leclerc taking advantage of what Gasly's done. Can Gasly get him back down into the Remus curve? He's looking back down the inside. This is amazing stuff. Down the inside, can Gasly get the position? And yes, he can. Gasly retakes 11, so Leclerc's going to have to work a little bit harder to get the position back. This is chaotic racing so far, as Evans is up to 8th. He's past Harrianto. But now Harrianto wants to get him back down the inside. Side by side they go. Harrianto and Evans, side by side. They go side by side through turn 4. And I think Evans has got the line going into turn 5. And he has. Evans moves into a points position. Up into 8th position. Giotto moves up to 10th. Well, still in 10th, I should say. But, as Zach Arianto is not wanting to give up on the New Zealand driver. He wants that point back off Evans. It doesn't matter if he's a championship contender. Arianto down to the inside of Evans. Not quite. Evans just hangs it around the outside. And Evans, for now, keeps on of 8th. Will Harrianto try and get him back down the pit straight? Let's see. I don't think he's close enough to mount an attack right now. But, as you look in the background, Gasly's having to defend from Leclerc. Leclerc looking to the inside. Leclerc down inside of Gasly. And Leclerc takes 11th off Gasly. Gasly's now got to worry about Marcello. And looks like, in fact, Rahal alongside Marcello looks like he's taking 13th. He thought he had, but then Gasly covered the line as they go up the hill. He's very able to keep alongside Marcello into the Remus curve. Let's see. Down inside goes Rahal, and Rahal moves up into 13th position, and Marcello falls into the clutches of Newgarden and Matsushita. In fact, Matsushita wants to try and get past Newgarden for that position, and Harrianto now looks like he's dropped back. Looks like he's dropped back from Evans. Evans now trying his best to catch up to Palmer, and it looks like Magnussen's catching up to Rozier for second place right now. So we've just got to keep an eye on what Magnussen's doing right now. Let's see then. So down inside goes Leclerc. Is he able to get the position? No. Giotto just hangs it around the outside as they go down the hill. There we go then. So, Giotto defending the inside. Leclerc looking to the inside into turn 1. Can Leclerc get 10th off Giotto down inside? And yes, he can. Leclerc moves up to 10th. And now Giotto has fell into the clutches of Gasly and Rahal. And Gasly takes 11th off Giotto. Giotto's gone back. And now Rahal looks like he's about to take Giotto. This is carnage. 4 of us. Four cars fighting it out into the Remus curve. Oh, that was close. Ray Hall takes advantage of this and moves up into 11th. Great stuff. And Giotto takes back 12th of Gasly, unless Gasly has the legs to get back in front. Side by side go to Giotto and Gasly down the back straight. And I want to check quickly, actually, as Magnussen's closing up to the back of his ear. And it looks like Gasly's just been able to hold off Giotto, who now falls into the clutches of teammate Marcello. And meantime, the battle for second is getting intense between Rozier and Magnussen. And, well, that's that then, really. So down the pit straight we go. So far, Rozier holds on to the fastest lap of the race so far. So at the moment, Rozier will get the two bonus points as they go through turn one. So, down the back straight they go then. And let's see the battling going on behind at the moment between the two Fantari cars. Fantari cars are fighting for 13th. Down inside goes Marcello. Giotto trying to squeeze his own teammate into the pit wall. Down inside goes Marcello. Has he done enough? No, Giotto just hangs it around the outside. Marcello falls into the Masashita and New Garden's clutches. Meantime, Magnussen's getting closer to Rozier. He wants that second place. As they go around turn five, Magnussen going around turn six and then through turn seven. Up the hill we go then. Into the last two corners, is Magnussen going to think of a move down the pit straight on Rozier? Round the final corner they go. Down the slipstream in, Magnussen looking to the inside. Rozier not thinking of defending. Looks like Magnussen got alongside him before Rozier could even think about defending. Down the inside, and Magnussen takes second place off Rozier. But is Rozier thinking of trying to find a way back past him? Looks like Mercedes cleared. Magnussen has cleared Rozier for second place. Now, does Magnussen have the pace to catch up to Rossi, who is, well, halfway down the back straight, may I point out. So that's a bit of a gap that Magnussen's got to try and catch up to. But Magnussen up into second place as these two are involved in a little bit of a fight, as his match is hitter. New Garland, Sainz has made his way up the field quite nicely, up into 17th. As now, up the hill they go then. And a bit of a lock-up from Sainz there, as he was witnessing Masashita defending from New Garden. Down the back straight they go. And down the hill we go then. As Lima's in. Why is Lima in? Is it a problem? There's a three abreast action going down into the Remus. I want to have a look at this. And yes, there was a problem. Lima's got a throttle problem. Lima's coming into the pits with a throttle problem. So that's not good for Lima. He was already last anyway, so this won't help his cause. Wouldn't be surprised because of the length of the track, he might be a lap down after this pit stop. In fact, he's going to be, actually, as Rossi just came down the pit straight. There was three abreast action going down the Remus curve there. I think it was between Daly, Yelly, and Di Silvestro. I might be wrong, as Yelly goes down the inside of Daly and moves up into 18th position. So that's that. Meanwhile, as it looks like Lima has finished his pit stop and he's rejoined just in front of Magnussen. Oh, I bet that. Oh, that was close indeed. That was so close indeed. I think that gave Kevin and Ollie a bit of a heart attack there. I think their hearts were in their mouth there. That was close there for Magnussen to end his race, but luckily just about able to get through there. Sorry, I had to take a little bit of a drink there. So, both band on, Emma's got to get a move on. Race leader Rossi Pitts. The race leader's in, as is Magnussen. So Rossi's in his stop, he's making his mandatory pit stop. Here we go then. as Magnussen is also in the pits. And it looks like the Netflix Motorsports guys are already in the pits. As Van Dorn stays out, Magnussen's doing his pit stop. And I believe that looks like Palmer's in the pit. And oh, Magnussen's having to wait for Palmer. Magnussen had to wait for Palmer. And there you go, Leclerc's also in the pits as well. And how much time do you think that might cost Magnussen? We'll have to see. Let's see. So Leclerc, as Palmer finishes his pit stop. And it's a 10.4 second stop for Leclerc. As Marcello's in as well. And he's just finished his pit stop. Anyone else pitting this lap? So at the moment, Razia currently leads this race right now. And I don't think he's pitting this lap. In fact, he's got a couple of laps of fuel to burn, as is Stevens. And we will be expecting Van Dorn, Evans, and I think Gasly to come into the pits as well. At the moment, Rossi has rejoined in sixth position. Meanwhile, Razia will head the leaderboard for another lap as Lynn tries his best to catch up to Stevens for what would be fourth position as Van Dorn pits. Right, Van Dorn then, he has to make sure today he keeps his championship hopes alive, because if he doesn't, he's going to be out of this championship fight. Van Dorn pits then. Van Dorn's in. It's a 10.4 second stop for the Etihad mechanics. Evans is also in the pit. He's just finished his pit stop. No hold ups whatsoever. Pierre Gasly's in. Gasly's in the pits right now. And we should be expecting, I think, Leclerc to come into the pits as well. Sainz is in for Netflix Motorsport. Gasly's just finished his pit stop. Mashashita, I'm sorry, is in the pits, as is Sainz. I think Leclerc's already done his pit stop now, I remember. Yeah, he has actually. So out of the pits goes, I think that's Giotto, who's just finished his pit stop. As Sainz and Matsushita finished theirs. Looks like Daly will be coming into the pits this lap. And we will be expecting Alex Lynn to pit. So Lynn's pitting this lap. And let's see. So around the last two corners on the track, and Lynn pits from third position. Rossi now sets the fastest lap. So now Rossi holds on to the two bonus points right now, as Lynn is also in the pits, as confirmation there. So Rossi's now holding on to those two bonus points. As Ray Hall pits. He pits from 8th and he comes out of his box. And Daly's in the pits. Di Silvestri is actually in as well. So here she is. Let's see how quick the GOM mechanics are. And it's a 10 second start. A good start from the GOM Genie mechanics. As looks like Daly's finished his pit stop. As Sainz is just down the pit straight. Razia pits this lap. So Razia into the pits. And let's see where Razia is going to rejoin after this pit stop. Is Stevens actually coming in? Yes, he is. You can just see that red dot in the mirror. Stevens is in the pits as well. So both Razia and Stevens pit. Let's see. See how quick the stop's going to be. And it's a 9.8 second stop for Alitalia. A good stop from the mechanics. Stevens is in his box. And he's finished his pit stop, so he rejoins behind Razia. Razia's currently fourth at the moment. Madison gets back his position because Harry Anto is still in the pit and he's currently second at the moment. But he's pitting this lap. So Razia still rejoins. in what will be a provisional third position. At the moment, Steven Stowe joins in a provisional fourth, and it looks like he's pulled a bit of a gap from Lynn from the last time we saw him. Meanwhile, Van Dorn has closed up to Lynn for sure. Van Dorn trying his best as Yaldi's in the pits. But I think we need to keep an eye on these two right now. New Garden's in as there's a battle behind. That's Evans side by side with Palmer for 8th position. Down to the inside, and Evans is in the point. So Evans moves up to 8th position as Palmer now having to defend from the clutch. In fact, Palmer wants a position back off Evans. He's looking back down the inside, but Evans shuts the door on Palmer. And that's that. So now they head down around the right hander goes Palmer. And that's that. So Evans is now in the point. And well, that's that. So as Harry Anto now pits from second place, let's see where he positions himself. I would expect him to be close to the points because there is a bit of a battle for that final point between Evans, Palmer and Leclerc right now. So let's see if Harry Anto will feed into that battle. And it's a 10 second stop, a good stop from the Alitalia mechanics. Let's see where Harry Anto rejoins. He's coming down the pit lane. 7th. There they are. That's that battle. Let's see where Harry Anto comes in today. He's got a little bit of a shortcut, remember? There they are, and he's just right, and he's a bit behind them at the moment. But he'll probably want to try and catch up to the three. So Evans is up to a provisional 7th right now. But that won't be enough still. He's got to get his foot down. Meantime, Van Dorn fighting for Lynn for a provisional 5th position right now as we look at the battle for 7th emerging between Evans, Palmer and Leclerc. Let's see, Leclerc down the inside into the second last corner. Gonna get the job done though. Palmer hangs it around the outside. Now they head down to the last corner. Down the pit straight we go then. Palmer defends the inside. Leclerc now flicks to the inside. He's playing his pace. Can Leclerc take 8th? Yes, he can. Leclerc moves up into a points position. Leclerc moves up into 8th. And now Harry Anto has been brought into this battle. And now up the hill they go then as Palmer defends the inside from Harry Anto because he knows that Rio is there in the mirrors for 9th position. Meantime, Van Dorn looks like he slipped back from Lynn right now. In fact, Lynn's actually catching to Stevens right now for 4th position. And meantime, let's head down the hill. Through the left hand, there we go then. Through turn 6 and then through turn 7, and is Harry Anto going to get onto the back of Palmer? Let's see. Tucking up into his slipstream. He's tucking up. He's not going to look through the tank in the last corner. I wonder if he's waiting for the pit straight. Down the last corner we go. Down the inside goes Harry Anto. Is he able to take Palmer for 9th position? Down the inside, but no, Palmer just hangs it around the outside. Now Harry Anto tucking up into Palmer's slipstream, looking to the inside. Can Harry Anto get knife off Palmer? Side by side they go up to the rumors curve. Down the inside, and Harry Anto takes knife off Palmer. Harry Anto moves up into ninth position, but can Palmer try and get him back down into turn 3? Looking like they're going to be bringing Ray Hall, I think it's Ray Hall, into this fight. Palmer looking back down the inside through turn 3. Can he get the position back? Yes, he can. Can Harry Anto just hang it around the outside? No, he can't. Palmer takes back ninth position, so Harry Anto is going to have to do it again to try and get back past Palmer. But Harry Anto's got to worry about Ray Hall behind as well. Meantime, Rossi leads, Magnussen second, Rozier third, Stevens fourth, Lynn fifth, Van Dorn sixth, Evans seventh, and Leclerc rounding out the top 8 as Palmer's still trying to defend from Harry Anto and Ray Hall as they go around the last two corners on the track. So far, Rossi is on lap 31 of 43, so we now have 13 laps of this feature race remaining. as Arianto goes down the inside. Is Arianto able to get the position down to the inside? And Palmer just about hanging it around the outside. Can Rahal take advantage of this? He looks to the outside now, flicks to the inside, gets back into the slipstream, and they've brought Gasly into this fight as well. Gasly side by side with Rahal for 11th. Fats are tucked back in, looking to the inside, looking to the outside again. Side by side they go. Can Rahal take 10th off Arianto? And he can. Up to 10th position goes Rahal. And now Arianto has got to be wary of Gasly for 11th position. For Gasly, as Gasly wants to try and take 11th off Arianto, as they might bring, I think that's Giotto, no, it's Marcello actually, into this fight. Arianto defended the inside, and Magnussen and Rossi. That is gonna be exciting, I can guarantee you. So, up the hill we go then. Stevens looks like he's dropping back now then from Rozier. And, hang on, hang on a minute. Unseen by the cameras, as Giotto pits, Leclerc's moved up to 7th. Leclerc has passed Mitch Evans. Giotto came in with a brake problem. So what does that mean then? It'll actually mean nothing, but that doesn't really matter for Orange Eyes Racing Junior, because Evans will still be out the championship. But as a result of this, Marjorie's Racing Junior will still win the Constructors at this rate. They will still win the Constructors. And wow, that's that. So Rossi, down the pit straight we go. As he heads down to turn one, we have 4 laps of this race remaining. Giotto's just finished his pit stop. I'm not sure if you saw in the pit lane down there, but Giotto has finished his pit stop. And around the final corner, and Alexander Rossi wins the sprint race here in sorry, the feature race here in Austria. Congratulations to him and the Marjorie's Racing Junior team. And it is official, this championship is going down to the wire. Magnussen crosses the line in 2nd place. And, well, that's it. Razia is going to pick up his first podium in, what, his 5th race in this? So around the final corner, and Razia picks up his first podium. Good on you, fella. Stevens crosses the line 4. Lynn crosses the line 5th. Van Dorn crosses the line 6th. Leclerc finishes in 7th position. Evans crosses the line in 8th. Van Dorn and Evans are out of the championship fight. But I do believe that means that Orange Eyes Racing Junior are the Constructors' champions. I think that is the case. Palmer finished 9th, Arianto 10th, Rahal 11th, Gasly 12th, Marcello 13th, Ugarte crosses the line 14th, Matsushita crosses the line 15th, Sainz crosses the line 16th, Yelly crosses the line 17th, Daly crosses the line 18th, Di Silvestro is going to cross the line in 19th, and that is that. So the winner is Alexander Rossi. The championship is going down to the wire, and it is between Magnussen and Rossi for the championship. And that is that. So, a reminder then of the results then. Rossi wins the race by 15.6 seconds in front of Magnussen in 2nd place. Razia is in 3rd with Stevens 4th, Lynn 5th, Van Dorn in 6th with the Leclerc 7th, Evans 8th. Van Dorn and Evans are now out of the championship fight. Palmer 9th, Arianto 10th, Rahal 11th, Gasly 12th, Marcello 13th, with New Garden 14th. And if we scroll down to the rest, it was Matsushita 15th, Carlos Sainz Jr. 16th, Nick Yelly 17th, Connor Daly 18th, Simone Di Silvestro 19th, Luca Giotto 20th, Fabio Lima 21st, and the only retirement was Daniel Abt. And it was Luca Giotto with that banker lap that he did on the penultimate lap, a 116.029. That is the fastest lap of the race. So, Van Dorn on the right, his teammate Magnussen is on the left. And who is going to get the lead into turn one? Who will win the championship? Two lights, three lights, four lights, five lights. For the final time, it's go! And who's got a good start between the two Etihads? I think Van Dorn's got a better start. Look at Vazir in the background. Vazir down to the inside of Magnussen. Into turn one, is Rossi going to head? Oh, there's a crash! There's a big crash! That's Rio Haryanto! He swerved into the track. There's more carnage in the background. But it looks like Magnussen is behind his championship rival. As Palmer's gone for a spin. But let's have a look at what happened to Haryanto. Right up over, he just tagged the back of Palmer. Did he collect anyone? And luckily, I don't think he did. But you can't tell, can you? It looks like somebody else has spun as well. We'll have to have a look. It looked like one of the... there you go, getting a look. We'll need to have a look a little bit further down. And oh, there was another carnage. There was another casualty. And it was Daniel Abt, who was another casualty. Let's have a look at another replay of him. So a chaotic start to the final race. So we go from the side. Let's see what happened then. And he had to slow down because of what happened to Rio Haryanto. And he gets collected. So Dale gets collected. There's carnage at the back. In fact, there's an Adidas Motorsport who's got involved as well. Who was that? I would think it might be Connor Daly. That's my guess. And it is Connor Daly who's got involved. But luckily for him, he doesn't crash. He hasn't retired this season. He doesn't want to end his run today. But a chaotic start as Palmer goes for a spin down at turn one. So a chaotic start to this sprint race. And well, confirmation, Haryanto out of the final race this season. And Abt also out as well. And Daly just about get out to rejoin, down to 20 cars already. Van Dorn leads. Vazir in second, Rossi third, Magnussen fourth. But that's okay for Magnussen because if the result stays as it is, Magnussen will win the championship. As now, looking at the background, it looks like, I think that's what, Ray Hall is it? I think it, no, it's Nugan down to the inside of Lynn, down the inside. Can he take fifth off Lynn? Yes, he can. Nugan moves up in different position. Lynn now in the clutches of Mitch Evans. Evans trying to get that final point. Indeed, he'll want to try and help his teammate Rossi if best he can at the moment. Both Stoffel and Mitch Evans will be playing supporting roles for their teammates as they go around turn 6 and 7. And it looks like Rozier's now in the clutches of Rossi. Can Rossi take second place? In fact, yeah, Rossi down to the inside of Rozier, but Rozier shuts the door on him. as they go around turn one. They complete lap one of the race. So after a chaotic start, Vandoorne leads, Razia second, Rossi third, and Vandoorne's having to defend the inside because Razia's trying to have a look for the lead into turn one. But Vandoorne shut the door indeed there, and Rossi's trying to get into this fight as well as they go down the back straight, which ahead them into the Remus curve. Rossi looking to the outside of Razia. Razia now looks to the outside of Vandoorne as they go up the hill towards the Remus curve. Razia's alongside Vandoorne. Can he take the lead? Down into the corners, Marcello's in the pit, and Louis Razia takes the lead here in Austria. His team are currently fighting for third in the constructors. That'll give him a big boost indeed. I think Marcello's in. For a reason, let's have a look. Why is Marcello in? Marcello is in because he lost his front wing at the start. Marcello lost his front wing at the start, and now he's got to come into the pits to change it. And that's that. So Razia leads, but Vandoorne trying to take the lead back, but Razia just shut the doors. Madison on the inside of his team, of his championship rival. Madison down to the inside, and Madison takes third off Rossi. Can Rossi try and get him back though? But now Razia leads, but Vandoorne's not going to give up that easily. Vandoorne wants to end his season on a high after being out the championship yesterday. The guys from second to fourth will be heading to the top class next season, and they want to finish their last races on a high. As now Vandoorne tucking up onto the back of Razia. Can he get the lead back off the Brazilian? Down to the inside, but Razia shuts the door on him into the second to last corner. Heading down to the last corner we go then. Down the pit straight. Tucking up into the slipstream. As Razia sets the fastest lap, but that won't do. Now Magnussen takes the fastest lap of the race then. So Magnussen will increase the gap even further. And at the rate, and now Newgarden set the fastest lap of the race. So now Newgarden holds on to them two championship points. Vandoorne wasn't able to get a jump on Razia. And it now looks like Razia has gone into the distance, and now Vandoorne's got to be wary of teammate Magnussen and Rossi. He'll want to help Magnussen as best as he can. Magnussen going to the inside, but he's putting him a bit of a fight. Now Daly holds on to that now. So Daly holds on to them two bonus points as well. Up the hill we go then. Now I should say that because of the game, the cars aren't programmed to do team orders, so Magnussen's going to have to do the work on track, I'm afraid. So, and out of turn three through turn four, and well, Vandoorne trying his best to hold on to his teammate. His teammate's going to get past him pretty soon because as he looks to the inside through turn six, they've got to be careful. Rossi's on the back of these guys, the two championship contenders fighting for second place right now. And now Magnussen down to the inside of his teammate. Rossi's alongside as well. Can Magnussen take it? Not quite. All right, Vandoorne's just shutting the door. And now Magnussen's fell into the clutches of Rossi. And it looks like they're bringing two more cars into this fight as well. Razia now sets the fastest lap of the race. So he currently holds on to the two bonus points. Magnussen looking to the inside of his teammate. Going to the edge of the pit wall. And he has to tuck in behind. But can Rossi take advantage of this? Rossi? No, not quite. Rossi has to tuck in behind Magnussen. Will this give him the run up to the Remus curve? As Lynn's looking at Newgarden for fifth position, but has to tuck in behind at the moment. So we have a five-car scrap for second place right now, as Newgarden and trying to find a way past Rossi. Newgarden looking to the inside, but not quite. Has to tuck in behind. Magnussen down to the inside of Vandoorne. Can he take second? And yes, he can. Magnussen finally gets past his teammate for second place. Magnussen up into second place, but can Vandoorne try and get him back as Newgarden trying to look for a way past Rossi now as they head down to turn three on the track. Vandoorne wants to try and get the position back off his teammate, but not quite. Magnussen keeping the door shut as they head down to turn three, and Newgarden down to the inside of Rossi, and he takes fourth off Rossi. That's going to do Magnussen a lot of favours indeed. Not Rossi, of course, but Magnussen. Breathe his pace now. Magnussen second. Rossi is down to fifth right now on the back of Newgarden. And it looks like Magnussen's now pulled a little bit of a gap between himself and teammate Vandoorne. Rossi wants to try and get fourth back off Newgarden as he tucks up into the sixth team. He's looking to the inside. Down to the inside we go, but not quite. Right, it looks like Newgarden's just shut the door on Rossi there as he head down the pit straight. We're now on. Razia is now on lap 5 of 21 And he's just controlling this race right now. As the 280 attempt down to turn one, Rossi trying to find a way past Newgarden, but it wasn't quite working. There's a battle in the background between Leclerc and Giotto. Leclerc holds on to seven for now as Giotto's into the clutches of Evans, who's dropped back just a little bit. Rossi now then looking at Newgarden yet again as they go up the hill. And Lynn trying to find a way past as well. Lynn now taking advantage of this. Lynn down to the inside of Rossi. Down to the inside. And Lynn takes fifth off Rossi. Rossi is down to sixth position. This is a disaster for Lynn as Daly's out. Daly has ended his consistent run of finishes. And Daly is out of the race. What's happened to him? It's an engine problem that's taken care of Daly. He's parked up at the last corner. Daly out the race. We're down to 19 runners. Marcello will be at the back of the pack. And an engine has gone for Connor Daly. And well, that's that. Meanwhile then, Rossi will try and want to try and take fifth back off. Lane confirmation that Daly is out of the race as we head down through turn three. And then through turn four we go then. So, through the left-hander. Through turn seven. Up the hill we go then. Lynn now looking to the inside of Newgarden. Can he take fourth? Not quite. Newgarden just hangs it around the outside. And I thought that would be actually quite an overtaking place. Because in my old league, there was one guy who actually passed there down at that corner twice. As now they head into turn one. Lynn looking to the inside. Newgarden trying to shove him into the pit wall. Lynn down to the inside. Can he take fourth? Yes, he can. Just about. Lynn moves up to fourth, and now Rossi gets back up to fifth as a result, and now Leclerc is alongside Newgarden, and now Rossi trying to get alongside Lynn. Leclerc moves up into sixth position. Leclerc now gets into the points, but now Newgarden wants to try and get him back down into the Remus curve. Rossi down to the inside of Lynn. Can he get fourth of Lynn? Down the inside, and side by side they go. They're going side by side. It looks like it was a little bit of a lock-up in the background, and Rossi takes fourth back off Lynn. Lynn had to turn back, and now Leclerc trying to take fifth off Lynn right now. This is incredible stuff. Newgarden, Lynn and Leclerc fighting for fifth position. Leclerc takes fifth. Newgarden down to the inside. Newgarden takes sixth off Lynn. And this is crazy stuff. They brought Giotto now into this fight as well. This is amazing stuff right now. Rosia leads. Magnussen in second place. Question is Magnussen doing what he did yesterday and catching to Rosia? That is the thing. Rosia has not won a race yet, of course. He would love to take a win in the last race of the season to end his season off as the top three look like they've spread out just a bit. Let's see what the gap is like then between Magnussen and Rosia as the Rosia starts lap 7 at 21. And the gap is heading through turn 1. The gap is 3.1 seconds, so we'll keep an eye on that gap. As Leclerc defending Newgarden again, Leclerc defends, and those four safe. Is that three abreast? Did I see three abreast going into that corner? Evans fighting with Rahal. Evans moves up to 10. Gasly, there's a big Lynn alongside Newgarden. There's too much to catch up on right now. Now, as the battle for safe is getting intense, down to the inside goes Lynn. Can he take safe off Newgarden? And yes, he can. Lynn moves up to safe. And now Newgarden's in the clutches of Giotto. No, he isn't actually. Giotto's have to get back because Sainz is now all over Giotto right now for 8th position. As now Newgarden trying to take 6th back off Lynn. And Newgarden's been able to get that job done. So Lynn's going to have to try again in a bit. Sainz had a look, but Giotto able to hang it around the outside. And that's that then really. So Rahal looks like he's got back in front of Evans for 10th position. And, well, let's have a look at the gap now then between Rosia and Magnussen as they head towards the end of the lap and start lap 8 of 21. Through the last corner. And the gap is, as we go in the cockpit of Kevin Magnussen, through turn 1, the gap is 3 seconds, so Magnussen's only taken a tenth out of his lead as Lynn goes down to the inside of Newgarden yet again, and he takes sixth yet again. But will Newgarden try and get him back? I don't think so this time. Looks like they've kept a consistent gap. Then again, New Garden might try and get back into the slipstream. Sainz is tucked up into Giotto's slipstream for 8th position right now. And in fact, it looks like all four of them are fighting for that final point, which Lynn is currently holding on to. Lynn defended the inside into the Remus curve. Approaching the last two corners on the track. Let's see what the gap is like now then between Razier and Magnussen as they head down to the last corner. The gap is, you just see that red dot in front of you, that is Razier right now. Let's see what the gap is. He did 1 minute 16.7 as Lima's out. The gap is 2 points. He's taken a chunk out of his lead there. He's taken 3 tenths out of his lead there. Let's see what happened to Lima. We're now down to 18 runners as a result. And oh, there was a crash between Lima and Di Silvestro. Di Silvestro and Lima's had a crash down at turn 5, in the middle of turn 5 and turn 6. Lima and Di Silvestro are out of the race. Looks like Di Silvestro made a mistake and she just pulled out on into Lima there. So not really sure what punishment you can give Di Silvestro for that, really, because it's the last race, of course, and she hasn't even got a seat for next season. Can't really disqualify her because she's also out of the race. Let's have another look. So there you go, look. So Di Silvestro understeers off and then she just doesn't see Lima coming. Lima's so close to rolling the car there, so lucky he didn't, but there's like debris all over the track, and that is another big crash indeed. Lima and Di Silvestro out of the race. We are down to 17 runners then. This has been a chaotic sprint race indeed. The gap between Razier and Magnussen is down to 2.6 seconds. The gap between Rossi and Van Dorn is 2 seconds. So that's that. As Sainz trying again to get onto the, trying to get past Giotto for 8th position. Confirmation there, Di Silvestro out of the race. Side by side we go. And Sainz has to tuck back into the back of him. So here comes Louis Razier as he just comes around turn 7 right now, as he'll now go up the hill and he will now approach the last two corners. This is only his 6th race in season 1 and he's going to win his first race and he'll get Alitalia 3rd in the constructors. Louis Razier wins the sprint race here in Austria. Congratulations to him and the whole of the Alitalia Junior team. Kevin Magnussen crosses the line 2nd. He'll be bitterly disappointed with that. And if we look in the background, Van Dorn finishes 3rd and Alexander Rossi finishes 4th, and he is the season 1 IFMC GP2 champion. Congratulations to the whole of the Orange Orange Racing Junior team. They have done it. Rossi has done enough to win the championship. Indeed there. Evans crosses the line in 10th. Massachita crosses the line 11th. Yelly is going to cross the line 12th. Stevens will cross the line 13th. Palmer is going to cross the line in 14th position. Rahal mysteriously has dropped down to 15th. We believe he made a mistake somewhere. And Rahal is going to cross the line in 15th position. Marcello, after that pit stop to change his front wing, will finish in 16th position. Quite a disappointing end to his championship. This time due to inconvenient circumstances, as Marcello comes down the pit straight. And he will cross the line in 16th position. And that is that then. So Louis Razier wins the race. Miserations to Kevin Magnussen. But congratulations to Alexander Rossi indeed. Here he is. And once again, congratulations to him and the whole of the Orange Orange Racing Junior team. He stopped on track for some reason. I wonder why that is. And surely we'll find out pretty soon. Oh, there you go. He's doing some donuts to celebrate. Rossi has done it. He's moving to the top class anyway, but Rossi is your champion, and well, he can celebrate all night after that. And well, that is it then. That is the season over with Rossi as your champion. So after all of that then, here are the results then from the sprint race. Louis Razier finished 1st with Kevin Magnussen 2nd, Stoffel Vandoorne 3rd, Alexander Rossi finished 4th, enough for him to crown him the first ever IFMC GP2 champion. Charles Leclerc finished 5th, with Alex Lynn 6th, Joseph Newgarden 7th, Luca Giotto finished 8th, with Carlos Sainz Jr. 9th, Mitch Evans 10th, with Nobuhiro Masashita 11th, Nick Yali 12th, Will Stevens 13th, Jolyon Palmer finished in 14th, Graham Rahal mysteriously finished 15th, and Marcello was the last finisher in 16th position. The retirements being Simona Di Silvestro, Fabio Lima, Pierre Gasly, Connor Daly, Daniel Abt, and Ryo Harianto. And the fastest lap of the race went to Louis Razia with a 1:16.485. That fastest lap was enough for Alitalia to claim third in the Constructors' Championship ahead of Willow's Grand Prix.
I can't wait. Inside is pleading, oh, and your heart's bleeding, and all you can see is red. Till you discover it is within each other to forgive and make amends. If I had known then what I know now, I wouldn't have said what I said. I took the long road, thought I'd be better on my own. Sometimes what's right is wrong instead. Cause I was too young and I didn't understand that you and I didn't understand that you are the one.